In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet, Completing the Square. Our directions are to find the value of C that completes the square. And there's a simple formula for completing the square when you have x squared plus or minus bx plus c. Now this can be plus or minus to complete the square because of the following. C is going to equal b divided by 2 and that quantity squared. So whether the b is negative or positive, squaring a negative will result in a positive, and squaring a positive will also result in the positive. So looking at number 1, in order to complete the square, our b value will be 38, and we can use either positive 38 or negative 38, because since we're squaring, positive or negative does not matter. So we'll have 38 divided by 2, and we're going to be squaring that. 38 divided by 2 equals 19, so 19 squared equals 361. So by completing the square, our C value will be 361 in number 1. And number 2, B will be 32. If we were to write it as plus BX, this 32 would be negative, although since we're squaring it, in the end, it will be positive. So remembering our formula is B divided by 2 squared. So that's 32 divided by 2 squared, which 32 divided by 2 is a positive 16, and we're going to be squaring that. 16 squared is equal to 256. So 256 is our solution in number 2. In number 3, we'll use a b value of 5/3. So our formula, b divided by 2 squared. When dividing by 2, if you're dividing it to a fraction, dividing by 2 is the same as multiplying by 1/2. So I'll do 5 over 3 times 1/2, and I'll square that. So that will be 5 over 3 times 2, which is 6, squared. Remembering my rules for exponents, that squared will be distributed to both the 5 and to the 6. So I will have 5 squared over 6 squared, which equals 25 divided by 36. And that can no longer be simplified, so 25/36 is my solution in number 3. And number 4, we'll use a b value of 24. So 24 divided by 2 squared will equal my c value in order to complete the square. 24 divided by 2 is 12, and 12 squared is equivalent to 144. So 144 is my solution. And number 5, 14 is the value we're going to use to complete the square. So 14 divided by 2, that quantity, squared. 14 divided by 2 is 7, and 7 squared is 49. So C is equivalent to 49 for number 5. And number 6, again, I'm dealing with a fraction. So remember my formula is b divided by 2 squared, which is equivalent to b times 1/2 squared. So I'm going to write this as 2/5 times 1/2 and that quantity squared. So that will be 2 over 10 squared. I'll distribute my exponent to the 2 and to the 10. So I'll have 2 squared over 10 squared, which will be equivalent to 4 over 100. 4 over 100 can be simplified even further since both are divisible by 4. 4 goes into 4 once, and 100 divided by 4 is 25. So 1/25 is my solution in number 6. And number 7, my b value is 22 over 13. So 22 divided by 13 times 1/2, I'm going to be squaring that quantity. That's equal to 22 over 13 times 2, which is 26 squared. Now before I distribute that 2, I'm going to simplify. Both 22 and 26 are divisible by 2. So that will be 11 over 13. So 11/13 squared. Distributing my exponent, I'll have 11 squared over 13 squared, which is 121 over 169. And number 8, I have a whole number 7 as my b value. So it'll be 7 over 2, or 7 times 1 half, squared. So I'm going to distribute that exponent to the 7 and the 2, since that fraction cannot be simplified. So I'll have 7 squared over 2 squared, which is 49 all over 4. 49 fourths is my solution in number 8. And number 9, again, I'm dealing with the whole number 17. So I'll have 17 over 2 squared. Distributing that exponent of 2, that'll be 17 squared over 2 squared. 17 squared is 289, and 2 squared is 4. This cannot be simplified because 289 is not divisible by 4 or 2, which are the numbers that 4 is divisible by. Therefore, 289 fourths is my final solution in number 9. And number 10, my b value is 42. So I'll have 42 over 2 squared. Now I can simplify 42 over 2 because 2 goes in evenly to 42 21 times. So I'll have 21 squared, which is equal to 441. 441 is my solution in number 10. And number 11, I'm looking at 34 as my b value. So 34 divided by 2 squared. 34 divided by 2 is a positive 17, and when I square that, I'll get 289. And again, as a quick reminder, whether the b is positive or negative, I will still get the same answer. If we were to use a negative 34, we'll have negative 34 divided by 2 squared, which is negative 17 squared. A negative times negative is a positive. Negative 17 times negative 17 is negative 17 squared, and a negative times a negative is a positive, and that would be a positive 289. So again, whether the b value is positive or negative does not matter when completing the square in this format. And number 12, we have a fraction, so as opposed to dividing by 2, I'm going to be multiplying by 1 half, but remember, they are the same thing. So 5 over 14 times 1 half, that quantity squared. That's 5 over 14 times 2, which is 28 squared. That fraction cannot be simplified, so I'll go ahead and distribute my exponent of 2. 5 squared over 28 squared is equal to 25 divided by 28 squared, which is 784. So 25 divided by 784, or 25 over 784ths, is my solution in number 12. And number 13, my b value will be 11 twelfths. So I'll take 11 over 12 and multiply that by 1 half and then square it. So that'll be 11 over 24 squared. So that's 11 squared over 24 squared. 11 squared is 121, and 24 squared is 576. So 121 divided by 576, or over 576, is my solution for number 13. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 14. My b value is a positive 5. So I'll take 5 and divide that by 2, and then square that quantity. Distributing that exponent of 2, I'll get 5 squared over 2 squared. 5 squared is 25 over 2 squared is 4. So 25 fourths is my value for C when completing the square. Join me in the next video where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 15 through 30. However, before you go on to that, click the like button and subscribe to my channel.